For generations, malls were a type of town square, a one-stop shop for restless teenagers and busy parents wanting to pick up gifts, fill out wardrobes, or just get out of the house. But in recent years, their future has been in doubt as online shopping games Steam and one-time anchor retailers like Sears and Macy's struggled financially and shuttered stores. Then came COVID-19. Now, as coronavirus vaccines roll out across the US, top-tier shopping centers are likely to bounce back in the new year, retail experts predict. But those that were in trouble before the COVID-19 crisis may disappear more quickly, as shoppers bypass them for malls offering a more upscale experience, or simply choose to click and shop online. In 2021, the good malls will continue to do well, said Neil Saunders, managing director of the retail consultancy Global Data. It's the weaker ones that will suffer. The future of the mall isn't doomed or completely redundant. It's just that 2021 will be a year of reckoning for underperforming properties. Stores struggled across the board in 2020, as local officials ordered all but those deemed essential to shut their doors or limit the number of customers to slow the spread of COVID-19. But malls were particularly hard hit during the pandemic. The temporary shutdown of movie theaters, gyms, and restaurants that were helping shopping centers stand out from Amazon and other online sellers dealt them a significant blow. Then in May, the bankruptcies of department stores and apparel retailers with a heavy commitment to malls started pouring in. Fashion chain J. Crew Group and luxury department store retailer Neiman Marcus Group filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection in the first week of May. JCPenney and Tuesday Morning, an off-price home goods retailer, also filed that month. A slew of fashion retailers filed in subsequent months, from Ascena Retail Group in July to Francesca's in December. As those mall staples shuttered stores, other retail tenants missed rental payments because of dwindling foot traffic, putting a dent in mall owners' income. Retail rental payments are ultimately funded by sales, said Tom McGee, president and CEO of the International Council of Shopping Centers. In a year where stores were forced to close and federal aid was insufficient, missed payments happened. Simon Property Group received roughly 51% of the rent it was owed by its U.S. properties for April and May, according to CoreSite Research. Mall owner Masaryk said that roughly 40% of its tenants paid the rent that was due for that same two-month period. And JCPenney, Nordstrom, and the Cheesecake Factory were among the retailers that had not fully paid their rent or were negotiating temporary rent reductions as of midsummer. In past years, the holiday shopping season kickoff was heralded by family and friends gathering to grab doorbusters.